for the last half of the inning, and that'll bring up the speedy outfielder Byron Buxton.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a boop and a glass, they could certainly use that right now.
And the throw to first will be in time, so they stamp out the bunt attempt. Fouled away. One out, nobody on. Behind 0-2 now. Oh, and they pulled the string on a good changeup there as he swings and misses, and he's set down on strikes for the second time tonight. He starts him out with a strike on the outer half. Hit the other way out toward right field. Piscotty on his horse. He can't get there, so the inning will continue. And he'll make it to second base now with two gone.
Now back, left field.
And now Eddie Rosario. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Hinders got it for out number three. Of the inning now, and now it will be catcher Mitch Garver.
The catcher.
First pitch of the at bat.
Garver.
Yeah. Tying run stands on deck, but it'll only matter if the guy in the box can get on base.
Yeah, and that has to be his mentality at the plate right now, man. He can't be the hero, so he needs to do what he can to give the guy behind him a chance to be the guy.
And now a curveball that's blown in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. Curveball misses here, so a good hitter's count now to 3-1.
Hey, leading off an inning in this situation, three balls on you. You have to know that a solo shot's not tying this game up. You have to find a way to get on base any way possible.
He struck him out. The third time he's fanned in the game.
The third baseman covers.
First pitch coming. Here it is. Starts him out with a slider for a strike. Ball that bounces up to the plate. It's 1-1. And the pitch. Bounce towards the second baseman. And there are two away now. Standing in, Jorge Polanco. Quickly down to their final four outs here tonight. And this pitch is taken on the inner half for strike one.
Shocked he didn't let it fly right there. Usually you're looking for a fastball elevated to get the party started.
Hit back up the middle. And that's through for a hit. So now to the plate, Luis Arraez. She'll take a look at a strike right down the middle. It's 0-1. Behind 0-2 now. And he's got himself another one. He picks up strikeout number 9 here. In the striding in to start the ninth, Sergio Romo. And they'll need him to get something going here. And that one slung through the strike zone that time at 98, 0-1. Grounder down the first baseline. He'll take this to the bag himself. One gone here in the ninth. Stepping up now, Byron Buxton. On the night, he's 2-for-4 with a pair of singles. And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1. That's in there. And he's deep in the hole now, 0-2.
That's a pitch he'd like to have back. You're not going to see very many pitches like that from a pitcher of this quality. I'm sure he'd like to have that one back to take a swing at it.
And with one out in the ninth, he's just now coming up on his 100th pitch of the ball game.
Yeah, Matty, he's going to finish this one on adrenaline if he's allowed to. We'll see how the manager plays this one. I know guys like Dan Plesac were locked and loaded in this position.
Oh, this is right now a dream if you're out in that bullpen right now. Your starting pitcher gets you into the ninth inning. The guys that, if they do get up in the ninth inning, these are the best relievers, and they're just lurking out there. What a terrific job up to this point.
Now the 1-1 pitch. And this will be a called strike two. And trouble now as they're down to their final strike tonight. Popped up. And this is going to wind up a foul ball. Two out, nobody on. Again, another foul ball.
Got to take advantage of that pitch right there. 0-2 breaker hanging over the heart of the plate. Not
swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over. So that'll bring in Byron Buxton. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. And the pitch.
Byron Buxton.
A high fastball is in there. Chop down the first baseline. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. So the bases are empty with one man gone.
And that'll bring up the outfielder, Max Kepler.
And he got him out in front that time. Strike one. It's over, but low. It's a ball and a strike. Now he turns on a fastball and sends it deep down the right field line. And that ball will stay fair, and it's gone. A home run. The big bat of Miguel Sano digs in next. So take a look at ball one. Can't get around quick enough, and that'll move the count to 1-1. Now the pitch. Swing and a miss at one in the dirt.
Murphy
gathers. And the throw is made to record the second out of the inning.
Got it.
Settling in now, Eddie Rosario. Looking to get on base and keep this first inning alive. And they start him out away with a ball strike. Rosario behind with an 0-2 count.
You go down 0-2 to a guy with this pitch arsenal, you just got to find a way to shorten up and battle, put something in play.
And he's safe at first, so a costly mistake on the drop third strike as now the inning will continue. Line drive to left, and that'll get down for a base hit. Josh Donaldson digging in now as he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one.
This is exactly the situation you drew up from an offensive standpoint. Good pitcher on the mound, but you got a chance to bury him early in this one.
Oh, at the green light there, but it's three balls and a strike now.
Let's get it going, boys. Somebody's loose, hitting 98 with ease in the first inning.
Grove is there, and the side is retired. Stepping in, Jorge Polanco. He'll lead things off here in this one-run contest.
A shortstop.
Rounded down the third baseline. And this is foul for the first strike. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. A ball and two strikes to the Twins shortstop. The 1-2. Misses for the second ball. And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2.
Pretty easy pitch to lay off there, 2-2. Not even close to being in the strike zone. He made it easy for the hitter in that one.
So he ran the fastball by him for the punch out. Jorge Polanco is dealt with for the first out in the bottom of the inning. No balls and one strike.
At the ball.
And he watches one dip low and inside for a ball, 1-1. Swing and he pops him up, but this will land untouched. The 1-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Here comes the first pitch.
The pitcher. Okay.
And that's taken for strike one. Bases are empty here with two men out. In there, and it's 0-2 now.
Yeah, I get it. They want to run this guy's pitch count up, but that was a pretty good pitch to hit.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three. And third baseman in tight, protecting the bunt, the first pitch. In there, 0-1. Behind 0-2 now. Nothing in two count, and the pitch.
One ball.
As a hitter, you got to be staunch in your game plan. You know he has a nasty changeup, and you got to fight to make sure it's in the zone.
No.
That's a great take right there.
Two balls and two strikes now. Three balls and two strikes to the Twins center fielder.
From 0-2 to 3-2, what a great at bat to start this inning off. Hey, this could be a productive inning.
Pulled high in the air out to left field. Pinder settles under it, and there's one gone. Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch.
Outside, that's the ball.
Ball and strike. Kepler is a very well-regarded defensive outfielder. Used to be the fielders were evaluated mostly by the eyeball test and simple stats like fielding percentage. But, of course, these days there are many more advanced ways that help determine a guy's work in the field. And in his case, he shines in many ways.
You know, Matty, for me, I think he does pass the eyeball test. I know you have to look at all the numbers and the analytics to really appreciate a ball player like this. But, man, does he come to work every day and play hard.
Here's Miguel Sano. As he'll fall behind here as he goes after the fastball that might have been out of the zone. It's strike one. And that misses 1-1.
That's not some bad pitching right there. You're two pitches down, but you have a runner on third, and you know this hitter is looking for something up in the zone that he can hit in the air for a sacrifice fly.
And
they're working the outer half here, but that one's wide for ball three. And that misses ball four. So with one out, that'll at least set up the double play possibility here that could get them out of the inning. And he lays off a pitch in there for the first strike. Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball. And the pitch misses low and away for ball two.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. But two guys already on. Pretty good shot. He's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger. And there are two away.
Come
set, the 0-1. Swung on and missed that strike two.
Not much you're going to do with that pitch right there. You have to catch it out front before it even breaks. And even if you do that, it's a tough pitch to keep fair.
Chapman brings it in on the first. And the Twins are turned away here as the side is retired. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And that brings up the former American League MVP, Josh Donaldson. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. Downstairs, two balls and no strikes. 2-0 on the way. Too high, and it's 3-0.
Kind of frustrating as a pitcher when you start an inning off with three straight balls like he has here in the fourth. Makes you start wondering what's going on.
3-1.
And that misses for ball four. The leadoff walk that starts the bottom of the fourth. First pitch of the at bat. Flying towards center field. In there. Base hit. Into the box now. Luis Urias. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. He's 0-1 thus far. And misses downstairs for a ball, 1-1.
count that fastball's
too much for him there, 1-2.
With the way this guy's throwing on the mound, you cannot be chasing. You have to set your sights a little bit lower and control the strike zone.
And the pitcher will indeed try and move his to get this one down. Only plays to first, so the pitcher does his job. It's a successful sacrifice. Set and the pitch. Big fastball, and he's well behind it with the swing. Swinging strike, and now it's 0-2.
Looks to me like he's trying to make adjustments pitch to pitch up there at the plate, but he's looked completely thrown off so far. Late on the first one, way out front on the second.
Hold the string on him. Strike three swinging. Throw to first is in time, and the inning is over. Max Kepler the next to grab a bat. Two hits and two trips for him thus far. Too high to start the inning. It's 1-0. And a slider stays outside, and he falls behind 2-0.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch. But if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
From the windup, the 3-0 pitch.
Now that's a really curious pitch selection. 3-0 and turned to the slider. You have to wonder if maybe he's lost the feel for his fastball.
Full count to Max Kepler, 3 balls and 2 strikes.
When you get yourself to a 3-1 count and you get a fastball, those are the ones you really want to punish. Couldn't get the bat on it, so we'll see if that comes back to haunt him.
Chapman is under it, and that's the first out of the inning. First delivery to him on the way. Fifth inning, 2-1 our score. Changeup laid off down around the shins. He couldn't pull that one back as he clearly broke the play to the plate, and that'll be ruled a strike. Into the corner and slicing foul. Try again, 1-2.
These last two guys are making them work quite a bit out there. Both have been long at bats, and all in all, he's had to make 13 throws just to them so far.
He can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an 8-pitch at bat. Didn't quite catch the zone there, ball one. Ball and a strike.
1-1.
One run, 4 hits. One error make up the totals for the Twins to this point. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. And he will strike him out. 10 now in the ballgame. Digging into the batter's box will be Hanser Alberto. He'll get things started now in the bottom of inning number 8.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop and a blast? They could certainly use that right now.
Swing and a ground ball to third, but a foul ball, 1-1.
Looked like he was cheating a heater right there. A little bit too far out in front. Got to find a way to keep his hands
down. Ball, 2 strikes.
Count moves to a ball and 2 strikes now. And he struck him out again. So that's the old sombrero there, partner. 4 strikeouts in the ballgame. Fastball, but couldn't quite find the zone. It's ball one. Boy, that fastball is just sizzling up there. 1-1. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Look out. That one almost got away from him. 2-2 now. Fastball didn't miss by much, and it's a full count now, 3-2.
One thing's clear, he's not afraid to pitch inside, right? One pitch ducks him away, then he comes right back with another one. So clearly this pitcher, he's not afraid to work that inner half of the plate.
Got him to miss the breaking ball there. Ramon Urias goes down for out number two in the bottom half.
Obviously, he's not fatiguing whatsoever. Still in the mid to high 90s with his fastball. These guys got to stay on the attack if they're going to have a chance.
And they'll try to tempt him with a curveball, but this bounces in front of the plate, and it's 1-2.
Hey, the fish ain't biting there on that 0-2 breaking ball, but you got to be careful because this pitcher might throw him another one.
They will strike him out. 10 now in the ballgame. And here's the big right-handed power threat, Trey Mancini. He's 2-for-3 thus far. And a strike called at the knee. Nothing in one.
Hey, in this day and age where everybody's watching the pitch count, that was pitch number 100 in the ninth inning, but he still looks awfully impressive on the mound.
And he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away. The 1-2. Swung on and missed, strike three. Anthony Santander the next to bat. 1-for-2 in the ball game thus far. Now a fastball a bit too low here. It's ball one. 2-0 to the Baltimore left fielder. Hold strike on the change, 2-1.
Gutsy pitch right there. 2-0 changeup for a strike. Good call by the catcher. Great execution by the pitcher.
3-1 to
it. 3-1.
Yeah. Strike two as the fastball is let
go. Three balls, two strikes.
This pitch is popped up. Olson in foul ground, and no one will track it down. Now a swing and a fly ball. And no one will track it down.
And when a guy starts leaving the curveball up, that's a sign he's beginning to tire a little bit out there. He's got to be able to get on top of that pitch, or he's going to start getting hurt.
Made a miss on the off-speed pitch that time. Anthony Santander goes down, and they've got only one out left to work with. Austin Hayes is in with two away now as he looks at a called strike one. Here's a little chopper up the middle, scooped up. Throw one to first, and the ball game is over. Standing in, Austin Romine. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The pitch.
Romine.
Really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
Not much you're going to do with that pitch right there. You have to catch it up front before it even breaks, and even if you do that, it's a tough pitch to keep fair.
And there's one down now. Now at the plate, Cameron Maybe. Now a swing and a fly ball. And it's a foul ball. Oh, and two, the count to Maven now. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone. So bases are empty here with two gone, and that'll bring up the big first baseman, C.J. Cron. High in the air down the right field line. Heading after it is Piscotty. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. Here's Jonathan Scope now, set to lead off the home half of the second. Swing and a miss, 0-1.
Some guys are great low ball hitters, but most guys, especially guys with pop like this, they're hunting for the ball belt high and above. So that was a nicely spotted fastball down in the zone.
And they'll try to bounce a curveball on 0-2, but he holds back. It's 1-2 now.
Hey, the fish ain't biting there on that 0-2 breaking ball, but you got to be careful because this pitcher might throw him another one.
So he chased out of the strike zone on that one. Jonathan Schoop is dealt with for the first out in the bottom of the inning. No balls and a strike to count. Pulls this one in the air out to left. Left fielder is on the move, and that's in there. Base hit. And he'll pull into second with one away.
That is good.
And that's a batter, Jamer Candelario. Fastball right back. And they'll just flip this on to first for the second out of the inning. Up next steps Kristen Stewart, runner in scoring position with Sugan. First pitch fastball in there for a called strike. Swinging strike, and now it's 0-2.
That's a real
swing and a miss. That retires the side, and here it comes. In there, strike one. Ball one as he lays off below the zone. A swing and a miss at a slider for a strike. Inside and a hair low. It's two balls and two strikes. A swing and a miss as he picks up another one to make it four strikeouts already, and there's your first down. At the knees, strike one. Setting him up inside as he swings and misses for strike two.
Man, if I'm on the mound right now, these guys are swinging at everything. Just want to try and paint the corners.
Taken in by Simeon. And that's the second out. Here's the first pitch to him.
Ball one.
Low for ball one.
Ball one, no strike.
That's by him one for strike one.
Boy, he set or cut that fastball. It comes in the high 90s, but that's a dangerous location, no matter how hard you're throwing.
And it's 2-1 to the Tigers' leadoff hitter. And a big swing and a miss here, two strikes.
2-2.
Swing and a miss at a big breaking ball, and that's how the inning comes. Here's Cameron Maben now. He's 0-1 thus far. Good fastball down around the knees there, taken for a strike. Hit hard on the ground is short. And that's out number one. So the base is empty here with one away. And that'll bring up the big first baseman, C.J. Krohn. And here's a fastball called for strike one.
You have to understand, as the hitter right here, pitcher on the mound wants a quick inning. Anything over the heart of the plate, probably got to pull the trigger on.
And he's keeping it down here, and that's a called strike two. And it's two balls and two strikes now. Here now the 2-2. Jonathan Schoop will be next. Oh, a big rip at the curveball, but he didn't get it, and he becomes the second casualty of the inning.
Number eight, second baseman, Jonathan.
Oh, and that one slung through the strike zone that time at 98, 0-1. And it's 1-1. And he comes back with a fastball, 1-2 now. He struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Hard on the ground towards short. Throw on to first, and one shortstop grounds out to the other, one away. pitch.
His command has been outstanding so far, hitting nearly all of his spots, and that's been a big factor why he's been so successful up to this point.
And very quickly there, they're two gone to start the inning. First offering on its way. Down the first baseline. That's foul. It's 0-1. Now the pitch. Grounded up the first baseline. Oh, and it eats him up a bit. And they'll have no play as he reaches first base safely. Stepping in now, Travis Kumari, as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike. And low, it's a ball and a strike. And here's a pitch swung on and missed. 1-2 now. And he struck him out, his eighth punch out of the ballgame. In now, Matthew Boyd. He'll have the opportunity to kick things off as we begin the home sixth. And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1.
Hey, the guy on the mound is absolutely pounding the zone, and that's why he's been able to stay and pitch deep into this game.
And it's fouled away. The next 0-2. Breaking ball called just a bit low.
Classic strikeout pitch right there on 0-2. It's the one we know he loves going to, but great recognition to lay off in that spot.
2-2. Just a swing and a miss. That's strike three. First pitch of the at bat.
The catcher. Off there.
Hit the other way out toward right field. Scotty's on the move. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. Coming to the plate now, Cameron Maybach, 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. There's a good fastball on the outside corner as we'll take a look at strike one. And that finds the target, nothing in two now.
Hey, with two outs in the number two hole, you're just trying to get on. You got the big boys coming up behind you.
And now he'll foul this one off as well to fall behind here. No balls and two strikes. Swing and a liner. Foul. No runs, two hits, one error for the Tigers thus far. And he will strike him out. 10 now. First offering on its way. And a fastball is in there for strike one. Just a bit late, and he's fallen behind 0-2. And a check swing. Did he go around? No, says the first base umpire. Ball one. And he struck him out. And there's strikeout number 11. In there, no balls and a strike. And it's 0-2 to score.
He's still looking great to me out there on the mound. Punched out the first guy in the seventh, and he's jumped ahead in the count right here. Looks like he could stay in this game a while longer.
Made a miss on the off-speed pitch that time. Jonathan Schoen comes the second out of the bottom of the seventh. The 1-0. It was offered at and missed for the first strike.
Even though we're late into this ballgame, this guy's deal is still top-notch. This guy's a horse.
Tiger shortstop with a ball and two strikes. Tough pitch to lay off there, but he did, and it's even up at 2-2. Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Feels it cleanly. Rolando Olson will take care of him at first, and that ends the inning. Now to the plate, Jaimer Candelario, 0-for-2 for him to this point.
Starting to run out of time. They haven't been able to score any runs as we're moving late into this one. A perfect time for this leadoff guy to try to get on base and ignite a rally.
1-1 the count. Into right field, that's a base hit. At the plate now, Kristen Stewart. She looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. Bounce towards the mound. There's one. On to first, and that's the very last thing they needed at this point in the ball game, as there are quickly two away now. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Way late on the fastball for strike one.
Hey, he's been able to pound that zone all night, working that outer half of the plate. That's why he's having so much success.
Behind 0-2 now. And he'll try and tempt him with one in the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's 1-2.
Well, that's a smart miss there. Sometimes guys will chase it down there, especially when they're in protect mode on an 0-2 count.
2-2 the count. Got another one. 13 strikeouts. Miguel Cabrera will be summoned to pinch hit here to start the bottom of the ninth. And remember, they need 2 to tie, 3 to win. So he's got his work cut out for him here. And it's the outside corner. It's strike one. And he falls behind 0-2. Hit on the ground for Simeon at short. Goes in time, and that's out number one. Next up for Detroit, Austin Romine. No hits in 3 tries so far. He struck out once. Good fastball down around the knees there, taken for a strike. Slapped hard the opposite way. Solid base hit for him, his first of the afternoon. At the plate, Cameron Maven. First pitch to him is taken a long way for ball one. He's hitless on 3 at-bats to this point.
Clearly working the bottom of the zone, trying to get a ground ball for a double play.
Now the 2-1 pitch to first. The second for one. Relay throw, but it'll be too late as he's well safe at first. First delivery to him on the way. C.J. Cohn is in with 2 away as he takes a ball 1-0. Hit in the air down the right field line. This will wind up being a foul ball. Hits this one hard the other way. He's got it. Throw on the second for the force, and the ball game is over. Now in the box, Alex Verdugo. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
The right fielder.
Grounded back up the middle. Simeon's got it. And the off-balance throw gets him. Nice play for the out. Standing in, J.D. Martinez. The fastball that gets the lower part of the zone called for a strike.
Let's get it going, boys. Somebody's loose, hitting 98 with ease in the first inning.
One pitch, a curveball that's right there. One ball, 2 strikes.
Hey, that's a great job by the pitcher right there, stealing a strike with that get me over breaking ball. And now he can get a little nastier with it in the dirt.
2-2 is a changeup that misses. 3-2. And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are 2 down. Now with the plate, Rafael Devers. Hoping to get on base and keep this first inning alive. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one. Tried to get him to go after the slider, but it's 1-1. Takes a look at a changeup there, and it's a ball and 2 strikes now. Slider whiffed on for strike 3. A great last first half of the second set to go. And that'll bring up the shortstop and one of the better two-strike hitters in baseball, Xander Bogaerts.
Well, that's
fastball just misses. That's ball one.
He's a veteran out on that mound. He understands he has to establish that inside fastball to open up the outer half of the plate.
Adam Hacken at the 2-0 change, and it's back 2-1.
Hey, boys, you talking about getting your ace swing off right here? That's what it looks like. A guy with massive power led the lead.
Rolled slowly down the third baseline. And this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. Oh, they really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out.
That's it.
Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. And this is low, ball one. Lifted the other way out to left center. Hinder will wait on it. And there's the second out of the inning. So digging in now, Christian Vasquez. He'll get to take his first cuts here. In there for strike one, 0-1. That fastball was a lively one. You could hear the pop of the glove all the way up here.
Hey, I admit I'm a little biased. There's nothing better than a pop of a glove on a good fastball. Looking forward to hearing a lot more of that.
Threw it right past him. A swing and a miss at the gas, and that in. First pitch on its way. The 1-0. Him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out. The pitch. First pitch fastball swung on and missed 0-1.
Hey, either this hitter needs a cup of coffee or he was sitting off speed right there.
Great job of changing speeds there. It's 0-2.
Looks to me like he's trying to make adjustments pitch to pitch up there at the plate, but he's looked completely thrown off so far. Late on the first one, way out front on the second.
Skied in the air to straightaway left. Hinder is right there as he'll put it away without much problem for the second out. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Bottom of inning number three, nothing-nothing our score. Now for the second batter in a row. This is in the air out to left field. And he dives to make a spectacular. Now at the plate, Paul DeJong. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Here's the pitch.
Paul DeJong.
In there for strike one.
0-1's the count.
Ball sets one. The target low here, and it misses 1-1. Right. Two balls and a strike to the St. Louis leadoff hitter. Hit down the third baseline, but this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. Fouls this one off. Can't find the zone there as he lays off the breaking ball.
You can bet these hitters are taking note of what the guy on the hill is working with. A long at bat like this in the first inning can reveal a lot.
He racks up a swinging strikeout on the breaking ball. Paul DeJong sent packing to begin the bottom of the inning. Harrison Bader comes on with one away as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0. Fastball, and that thing's a blur up there, folks. 1-1. Bader is a guy that has a lot of speed, no doubt about that. And while that's certainly a weapon for him offensively, it could be argued that it benefits him just as much on the defensive side of the ball, given the position he plays.
And not only just speed, but first step quickness speed.
He's able to track balls down that other guys cannot get to. And sometimes that's half the equation.
Breaking ball swung on in the dirt. Makes the throw to first. Two down. And that brings up Paul Goldschmidt, looking to get on base and keep this first inning alive. Just able to get a piece of that for strike one. A ball and a strike to the Cardinals' first baseman. Checks his swing here, but he does so in time. Two out, nobody on. Swing and a miss. Does that look like self-defense there? It's two and two.
Not much you can do with that one. Tied him up in knots.
And a full count to Paul Goldschmidt. Three balls and two strikes. Smoked on the ground up the middle. And Goldschmidt's aboard. It's a base hit. Colton Wong will stand in. As they take a look at a strike on the outside corner, it's 0-1. Hit out toward second. Scooped up. Throw to second for a force out. The side is retired. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And next to hit is the catcher, Yadier Molina. Fastball just missed above the zone. One ball, one strike to count. Now here's the pitch. Line toward the alley in left center. And Molina's aboard a base hit. Digging in now will be Matt Carpenter. As he will take a fastball in there at the knees for strike one. Look at a fastball just off the black, and it's even at one. Takes a look at a changeup there, and it's a ball and two strikes now.
Probably better that he let that pitch go anyway. After seeing a lively fastball on the pitch before, it's pretty hard to sit back enough on a well-thrown changeup.
And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. Hit hard to the right, but foul. To third. Chapman's got it. One there. Relay to Olsen. They turn the double play, and that retires. Here comes the first pitch.
At the ball.
And it is wind up. Here comes the 1-0. Swing, and a miss for strike one. Fowler behind a ball and two strikes.
One and two.
Not much you're going to do with that pitch right there. You have to catch it out front before it even breaks. And even if you do that, it's a tough pitch to keep fair.
And a good throw gets him one gone. Ready. Here's the first offering.
Hey.
Bottom of inning number three. Nothing, nothing our score. Big swing and a miss at the fastball, and he's behind in the count 0-2.
Sometimes you just can't overthink it. If a guy can't hit a certain pitch in a certain quadrant, why would you throw him anything else? Case in point, this guy's cold zone is away, and this pitcher keeps his back in that exact spot.
Breaking ball, called third strike as that catches the zone for out number two. And he swings through a fastball and doesn't catch up with it. It's 0-1. Bouncer to the left side, and the inning will continue as that's through for a two-out hit. So that'll bring in Harrison Bader. And the first pitch to him is a changeup, but can't find the zone. It's ball one. Good fastball as he gets the swing and a miss. Swing and a miss, and it's a ball and two strikes here.
Got him to chase after the curveball below the zone there. That was a really nice hit.
We'll have to leave it there as this is strike three. Bottom of the inning now. And next to bat will be the first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt.
This game is rolling right along as we move into the middle innings with no score. You'd think by now one of these two teams would be able to get some base runners on and get him in, but that hasn't been the case.
set up away with the changeup, but it's one and one. Two balls and a strike to the St. Louis leadoff hitter.
Two balls.
Well, that backdoor breaking ball just missed right there. It's a very effective pitch. You can hit the outside corner of that pitch, it's unhittable.
Fouled away. The 2-2 one more time. Swung on and missed, strike three. First offering on its way.
Second baseman.
Little chopper back to the mound. And there's out number two. So two are gone now for Yadier Molina. In there, the knees, strike one. One and one. Two balls and a strike to Molina. Hit well on the ground to first. Oh, what a stop on the slide. Wow. He's ready. Here's the first offering. And that's in there for strike one. And he falls behind 0-2. Nothing in two count and the pitch. Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out. Now here it comes. And that one swung on and missed 0-1. Down the way, ball one. Oh, right back to him on the mound. Just flip this on the first for the second out of the inning. The pitch. First pitch hack in here, and that's the first strike.
Little hesitation right there by the batter. It was great execution by the pitcher down and away. That looked like a late swing. Could have been sitting on something else.
Into the corner and slicing foul. Ready with another 0-2. And he struck him out. His eighth punch out of the ball. So striding in, Ryan Helsley is getting his first plate appearance of the game here in the sixth. Check swing, but he held up in time. Ball one. Lays off the fastball away, and it's 2-0.
In this situation right here, I'm protecting my pitcher from himself. I know he wants to swing the bat and let the boys know in the clubhouse that he can do his job, but I'm probably putting a take sign on right here.
Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. Oh, he's really got the strikeout pitch working now as he notches number 9 in the ball game. Ball 1-0. Ball and a strike. Well below the knees, laid off on the changeup there. Nip the corner. 2-2.
I got the count. 2-2.
And he struck him out. The 10th victim sat down on strikes thus far.
The better view. Harris there.
Way behind that pitch, it's 0-1.
This could be a huge win for the guy on the mound if he's able to get out of this inning 1-2-3 and start fresh next inning with the middle of the order.
Down low, two balls and a strike.
A couple of strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at bat trying to get ahead and put himself in a good hitter's count.
3-1 pitch.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
Had to sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one. And he takes ball four, so he's on. And as you know, that often means the steal could be in order here. Off the plate and away there. One ball, no strikes. That one's going to find the seats. Strike one. Fouled off again, and now he's in a 1-2 hole. Looking to punch him out again. The pitch.
Nope, that's down.
To two balls and two strikes now. And yet another strikeout here. His 11th. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. And he throws the fastball by him here. 0-1.
In today's game, with velocity and exploding breaking stuff, you have to find a way to control the strike zone as a unit. They haven't been able to do that today, swinging at way too many pitches outside the zone.
But an easy play there at first as that becomes the first out of the inning. Here's the pitch. No runs, three hits, and no errors so far for the Redbirds. There's one at 97, and all he can do is foul that one away. Well hit, but also well fouled into the seats and left.
He was looking for a swing and a miss breaker right there, but left that one in the zone that got fouled off.
Swing and a blooper to the right side.
Piscotty.
He's there, and he makes the catch for the out. Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch.
No, that's
below
down.
The knees, one ball, no strikes. And he fouls this one off. Right side. Olsen takes it on his own, and the inning is over. Bottom of inning number 8 set to go, and into bat next will be Tyler O'Neill.
It doesn't look very promising so far in this one as we move into the later innings. Down by a bundle, it's time to get some base runners and hopefully a long ball to get them back into this one.
1-1. Fouled off. The 1-2. It's a wave and a miss. He struck him out. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. And a look at a fastball that doesn't miss by a whole lot. It's 1-0. Hit in the air down the right field line. Piscotty on his horse. And no one will track it down. 1-1.
Whoa, that's down.
No runs, three hits, and no errors so far for the Redbirds. 2-2. Got him. As he just continues to mow down these hitters. 13 strikeouts. Tommy Edman will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher. Fastball here as we'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. Attempt to put the ball in play for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. Sliced hard on the ground. Rowanda Olsen will take care of him at first, and that ends the inning. All set for the bottom of the ninth. And stepping up is the shortstop, Paul DeYoung. Strike one to start the at-bat. Nothing in one count. Here it comes.
Hey! No balls, two strikes.
Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game. Good fastball down around the knees there, taken for a strike. And it's quickly 0-2. Bases are empty, one man out. Got him! And he goes down on strikes for the third time.
Up next, Martin. The first baseman.
And a check swing here, but he clearly went around on a pitch that would have been a strike anyway. It's nothing in one. Oh, that hit him. Let's hope he's okay. And they'll have no play as he reaches first base safely. Here's Colton Wong now. As he lays off a fastball too low for ball one. He could really use a knock here. 0 for 3 in the game so far. And I believe they'll say he broke the plane. As yes, he did. It's ruled a strike. Unable to get the bat around in time, and the count evens at 2-2. Good eye to lay off the slider there, and he works it to full 3-2 here.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Catch is made, and